On Sunday morn, young Lambton went a-fishing in the weir, and catched a fish upon his yacht, he thought looked very queer. But what the kind of fish it was, young Lambton couldn't tell. He wadn't fast to carry it yet, so he hoid it down a well.
Wish that I could tell you another story. Wish that I could tell you
Lambton felt inclined again in fighting foreign wars. He joined a troop of knights that cared for neither wounds nor scars. And off he went to Palestine, where queer things him befell, and very soon forgot about that queer worm in the well.
Wish that I could go to tell you another story. Wish that I could go to tell you who the war.
The worm got fat and growled and growled and growled an awful size. He grit big teeth, a grit big gob, and grit big goggly eyes. And when it needs, he crawled about to pick up bits and ewes. If he fell dry upon the road, he milked a dozen coos. This fearful worm would often feed on calves and lambs and sheep, and swally little bairns alive when they lay down to sleep. And when he'd eaten all he could and he had had his fill, he growled away and lapped his tail 7 times round Pencher Hill. The news of this most awful worm and his queer gannons on soon crossed the seas, got to the ears of brave and bold Sir John. So then he came and catched the beast and put him in 3 halves, and that soon stopped his eating bairns and sheep and lambs and calves. So know you now how all the folks on both sides of the weir lost lots of sheep and lots of sleep and lived in mortal fear. So let's have one, the brave Sir John, that kept the bairns for harm, saved coos and calves by neck and hands of the famous Lambton Worm. No lads have had me, no lads have had me.